Ernesto and Frida destroyed our lives. I hope that you remember that.
You're right. They started everything. Frida ordered them to kill my baby.
These years, you still haven't forgotten about your child with Ernesto?
Camilo, it's impossible for me to ever forget about my child. I still dream of my baby every night.
But that child is the result of Ernesto's cruelty.
Camilo, she's still my child, of my blood.
Your child's dead. Forget all about her. It's time to build our own family, Orlando.
Good morning, Dr. Frida.
Don't worry, I'll go straight to the point. Kirat, there's just one reason why I'm here. Did you or did you not obey my orders?
Yes, sir, I'm on it.
Let's follow Orlando. Come on!
Tell the truth! Kirat! Did you get rid of Orlando's baby, just like I ordered you to?
You know, We were afraid of what you'd do to us if you found out about the child. So we told you that... we told you that we killed the baby. But somebody took the child. That's the truth.
How dare you! I am warning you, Kirat. Don't you even think about telling anyone about Orlando's child. If you don't want anything to happen to you or your family, do you understand?
You know, I no longer have a family. I lost everyone I loved since I started working for you.
Cello? Lawrence?
Mother! Mother, I didn't know that you kept that.
I don't know. It was as if I was waiting for this day to come. I know that you're still in love with each other.
Thank you, Ma'am Lupe.
Mother.
Well then, I'll leave you two alone, huh?
Okay.
She's so cute.
Lawrence, look at this.
What is it? Shallow? Mm-hmm. I hope you don't forget about tomorrow. Shallow?
Our anniversary.
I thought you didn't remember.
How could I forget?
That's why I'm inviting you on a date.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see each other tomorrow. Mm-hmm. I've got something for you. Let's just say it's a big surprise for you.
It can't be Orlando's daughter, Shallow.
Got any news?
Ma'am, I'm calling you from the local jail.
Frida was here visiting an inmate. I didn't hear most of the things they said, but I did catch something about a child the inmate was supposed to kill. Then Frida was furious and slapped the guy. What do you want me to do? Hello? Hello, ma'am.
Okay. I want you to follow Frida. Watch her every move and keep me posted.
Yes, ma'am.
I'll take care of the inmate Frida spoke to.
It's really good to have you back, Derek. And so how is your sister?
She's doing all right in Davao. By the way, boss, I'd like to introduce you to my friend Alan. Maybe he can be some help to us.
Perfect. You're just in time because I really need new bodyguards. Did Derek tell you what kind of work you'd be doing for me?
Yes, sir, he did.
I told you.
Oh, here's Essing.
Good morning, Sir Essing, Mam Lupe.
Good morning.
Essing, where's Shello?
See, I told you it'd be all right.
Yes.
Well, I'm asking you. Axel's been waiting for hours at the house. He was getting bored, so I took him here with me.
I I think she's upstairs.
Laurent.
Wait a minute. I'll call her.
Okay.
Oh, here's Shallow now.
Hi.
Hi, Shallow.
Shallow. Axel was wondering if you wanted to go out with him.
Why, Shallow, are you busy?
It's okay, Shallow's not busy, right? It's okay, Shallow. I think you should go out with Axel. And he said he'll make sure you get home safely. And besides, you'll be escorted by presidential security.
Shallow?
Go on, Shallow. Why don't you go out?
We'll go ahead. All right, sir, thank you.
All right.
I'll take good care of her.
He said something about a baby he didn't kill. A baby he didn't kill. A baby he didn't kill. A baby he didn't kill.
Orlando! Orlando! I saw Frida's men. They're on their way here.
What? What should we do?
We have to hide the children.
So there's something I want you to know.
Mm-hmm.
I'm seeing Lawrence and I love him. You and I are just friends. I hope you understand.
You know that your uncle hates Lawrence. He hates his family. He keeps telling me all these plans, like how he'd love to see them fall. You have to be careful, Shallow. Things won't be easy for you, and especially for Lawrence, when your uncle finds out about you too.
Ma'am, it looks to me like that car is following us.
Make that turn.
Okay.
Hello. Yes, I need some backup. Someone is following our car. We're at the Balagtas Highway. I need you now. I think we should pull over.
So tomorrow then. Okay, sure. Shallow.
Uncle.
Axel. Good morning.
Good morning, sir. Thank you.
Axel, I'm inviting you to the awarding program for the new scholars of San Ildefonso College. I would like you to come.
Sure, sir. I'd love to go.
Shallow, why don't you join us?
No, it's okay, Uncle Camilo.
Come on, Shella, we won't take long. Please.
Shello, why don't you listen to Axel? Axel, don't worry. I will convince her to join us.
All right, then.
What's important is that you're going to this event. Everyone will be glad to see the president's son.
Lawrence? Lawrence?
Father.
Oh. Where have you been?
I went to see Shello. Come in. I went there to talk to her father Essing and to Lupe. I already told him the truth about us.
I'm glad to hear that.
It's a big step for me. But Father, here's the thing. The real problem now is Mother and Shello's Uncle Camilo. Father, is it really that impossible for you to somehow work things out with Camilo?
Lawrence, you know, it's not that easy.
Father, that's the only way I can think of so that I can be accepted by Camilo.
Ma'am, I'm afraid I have some bad news. It's Julio. He was found dead inside his car.
That Frida. This all smells like Frida. Call the administrator of the municipal jail. I need to talk to an inmate. And tell them to make sure that this inmate is kept safe from any harm.
Yes, ma'am.
You're welcome.
Néstor Icaro, Eduardo Vargas, Neil Ryan Sessin.
What? But I'm already here. Can't you sneak out or something?
I'll need my Aunt Orlana's help, but she isn't here. I'll try to sneak out.
What's that event anyway? You really have to be there? Is Axel there?
Yes.
Where are you?
You're alive. Why did you bother to come back?
Tell me why Frida was here. What did she want from you?
It's been quite some time since you visited Dr. Frida. What can we do for you?
My apologies, Mother. I've been very busy lately. I wanted to see you because I'd like to see the records of Shello San Carlos. She was under your care here at the orphanage.
I'm begging you. Please tell me the truth. What happened to my baby?
Sorry, but I've chosen to forget about that night.
Please have pity on me. I need to know the truth. I can help you get out of here. I can talk to Governor San Carlos.
There's no need to do that. I haven't got family. Tell you the truth, I'm used to living in prison. And I'm never going back to work with the likes of that doctor.
What happened to my baby? Answer me.
We didn't kill your child, Orlando.
I'm sorry, Frida, but we don't give out the records of the orphans.
Mother, Shella's left a long time ago. And I'm just interested because she's so dear to us. She's my son's best friend, you know.
Even so, it is our policy to protect all the orphans. I know that you have helped this orphanage with your regular donations, but I'm really sorry. Those records are confidential.
My child is alive.
A pleasant afternoon to all of you. We are very lucky this afternoon because here to grace our program is none other than the son of our most beloved president. Let's give a round of applause to Mr. Axel Rivero. And also here with us today is my very lovely niece. Can you help me give her a round of applause and welcome Michelle San Carlos?
Governor.
Yes?
It seems that the president's son is always in Monte Gracia. Could it be that he's courting Shello?
You know, I've wondered about that too. Why don't we ask him? Axel, you ought to be the one to answer that question. Friends, what do you think? Well?
You think so too?
Yes, I am, and I hope that it's okay with you.
Control. I'm sure this is just another one of our enemy's tricks. The incident is nothing. We've got it under control. Now let's go on with our program.
Derek, stop it!
Huh?
Lawrence, get off it! Derek!
Derek!
Please, get off it, please!
Huh? Uncle. You want to fight? Huh?
Uncle, please stop.
You want to fight?
Please,
pick
uncle.
Him up.
Huh? You're a coward
uncle,
now, aren't
please.
You? You want to fight? Huh?
Please, Uncle, huh? Derek,
you want to fight?
Uncle, please,
hey, Lawrence, you've really got some nerve. How dare you show your face here?
Uncle, please. Uncle, please, no, stop it. I love Lawrence.
What did you say?
Shello.
Please, I beg you, Uncle, don't hurt him.
Shello, that's enough.
Please. Uncle, please don't hurt him. Please. Uncle. Uncle.
Well, Trinidad, if you don't stay away from my niece, Shello, this is nothing compared to what I'll do to you. Remember that.
Uncle, please stop it. Uncle, please stop, Lawrence.
Let's go, Shello.
Please, please,
Derek,
Uncle, don't hurt him anymore.
You take care of him.
Leave it
please,
to me, boss.
Uncle, please.
Come on, Shello.
Lawrence!
Come on!
Lawrence!
Do you want some more?
Axel, if it's okay, come back some other time. I'm sorry for what happened. Don't you worry. I made sure that Lawrence learned his lesson.
All I ask is that you don't hurt Cello.
Derek, Alan, why don't you step outside?
Watch your step. Camilo? Camilo, what happened?
Why don't you ask your daughter? I cannot believe what just happened. Your daughter is meeting up with Lawrence again. And you, Shelo. From now on, you can't so much as step out of this house without a single bodyguard. And I want to know every move you make. And tonight, I want you in your room. You can't go out. You can't use the telephone. And give me that cell phone. I said, give me your cell phone. I don't ever want to hear about you seeing Lawrence ever again. Because if you do, I'll break every bone in his body.
Uncle, we're not doing anything wrong. Please try to understand us. We've got nothing to do with your feud with Uncle Ernesto. Uncle Camilo, I love Lawrence.
Love? Do you know what you're saying, Shelo? You cannot fall in love with someone as filthy as Ernesto's son. Is that so hard to understand? Don't you ever disobey me, Shelo.
Uncle Camilo, I respect you and I know I owe you a lot. But I love Lawrence.
Camilo, that's enough!
Your daughter's going too far, Esseng!
Camilo, you have no right to lay a hand on Shelo. I'm still her father.
I want you to remember, your family is nothing without me. And as long as you're in my house, you do what I say. And the very first thing I want you to do is to stay away from Lawrence. Do you understand? Because if you don't, you can all get out of here and live like tramps in the street. I'm really sorry, Mr. President. I'd like to apologize for what happened. My enemies won't stop at anything to destroy me. That includes their good-for-nothing son.
It's all right, Camilo. I've been asking Axel to come home, but he doesn't want to. He worries about Shelo. At least the press know that the incident was politically motivated. I don't want my son involved in a scandal.
Please don't worry, Mr. President. I've made sure that this won't happen again. I'll take care of Trinidad.
Very well, Governor. You know what to do.
Good evening, ma'am.
Orlando, I was waiting all day. Do you know that Shello has been seeing that stupid son of our enemy, Ernesto?
How is Shello?
I've talked to her. Where have you been?
At the prison house. I talked to one of Frida's old bodyguards. Camilo, they didn't kill my child. My child is still alive.
You have to eat.
I don't want to.
Dear.
Father, why is he so cruel? He's so mean. He doesn't understand me. He's so strict that he's not even my father. Father Lawrence and I are not doing anything wrong.
Forgive me, Shello. I feel so helpless. Shello, if only I could give you and your mother everything that you need. If I could only send you to school, this wouldn't have happened. But Shello, I promise I won't let Camilo do this to you. He has no right. He may be the one supporting us, but he can't control your life. I'll do everything I can to work things out.
Father, it's not your fault. I love you.
We both love you so much, Shello.
Mother.
Shello, my dear. Shello, you know that I'd give my life just to make you happy. I love you so much, Shello.
I've suffered for 18 years, Camilo. For 18 years, I carried the memory of that night. The night I thought my child was killed. I was living with Nena. And then Frida's bodyguards came. Nena and I tried to hide, but it was too late. I ran away with Nena's child and my baby. But they killed Nena.
Nena had a baby?
Yes. Her baby with Cario, who was then working in Manila. I kept on running till I got to the church, and there I hid the two children. I misled the bodyguards of Frida.
And just how sure are you that they're really Frida's bodyguards?
Nena knew that they were with Frida and Camilo. You know what she's capable of doing. You know that. Camilo, I almost lost my mind that night. I didn't know what to do. I was blaming myself for what happened because I couldn't even protect my child.
You know, Gian, I'm okay.
Lawrence, please, just stay put. Well, you know what they say about love, right? It hurts.
You know, that's not funny.
Lawrence, I'm sorry. I'm just worried about
you. Stop it, will you? I'm fine, it's nothing. I'm more worried about Shello. I don't know what her Uncle Camilo might do to her, you know? Gian, you have to promise me. Don't tell my parents about this. I'm sure they're just going to get mad if they find out.
Lawrence, get real. Your mother and father are sure to find out. They've probably seen it in the news.
And I guess it's for the best, so that they can protect you. I think you should go home first.
I don't know, Gian. I think I'm losing my mind. I don't know how I can get to talk to Shelo. I really need to see her.
Frida's bodyguard told me that my child's alive. I don't have any proof, Camilo, but I really feel that what he told me is true.
Don't be too impulsive, Orlando. How can you ever believe anything that that murderer says? You never know if he was just lying to you.
It's true. I know. I'm going to find my child, Camilo.
Good work. Thank you.
Father, I'm okay.
If I didn't read about it in the newspapers, I wouldn't have found out. What's gotten into you, Lawrence? Why did you go there? Why did you make a scene?
That Axel's messing with my girlfriend. He already knows about us. But is so persistent. That's why I couldn't help myself. Does Mother know about this?
I haven't spoken to your mother yet. She's been distant since you left. But do you honestly think you can hide something like this from your mother?
Well, I guess this was really meant to happen. At least now, everyone knows that I'm seeing Shelo. Right? Father, we'll fight for this. Nothing and no one can separate us.
Shelo, your mother told me you haven't eaten since yesterday.
Orlando, have you got any news about Lawrence?
Your Uncle Camilo is upset, Shelo. He's very angry. He swore that if he finds out that Lawrence tries to see you, that would be the last straw. Shelo, I don't want to scare you, but I'm telling you this so you know. I'm really sorry. If I were here yesterday, this wouldn't have happened.
Don't be sorry, Aunt Orlando. What happened is nobody's fault. What I don't get is why Uncle Camilo refuses to understand us.
I'm sure he knows how it is to love, right?
Shelo, you can't blame your Uncle Camilo. We're both victims of Lawrence's parents. I was going to marry Camilo when I was raped by Ernesto. Then I got pregnant. Then Frida had my baby killed.
What?
So now you understand why. Why, Shelo, we hate them so much. But Shelo, I've learned to love Lawrence. But you know, I've got good news. Yesterday I wasn't home because I found out that my child's still alive. But I don't know. I don't know where she is.
Aunt Orlando, I hope you find her. You need to be with each other. So she can find out how lucky she is to have you as her mother.
Shelo.
Aunt Orlando, please help me. I need to see Lawrence. Aunt Orlando, please.
I don't know what to do anymore, Lupe. Camilo's my brother, and I owe him a lot. But I'll forget about everything if he continues what he's been doing and hurt Shelo this way.
The date Shelo was brought to the orphanage was the same date I ordered the child to be killed. Abandoned beside Monte Gracia Church. Father Felix Pico brought the baby to the orphanage. They found a necklace with a ring on the baby's neck. Shelo. Shelo is Orlando's daughter. Could this be possible? I want you to kill Shelo. I don't care how you are going to do it, but just do what I tell you. And this time around, make sure you don't fail. Or else, you'll all end up dead.